A law professor proposed Monday that two major edits must be made to the U.S. Constitution in order to place new restrictions on the First Amendment and Second Amendment. Marianne Franks, law professor at the University of Miami Law School, published an essay in the Boston Globe advocating that both amendments be edited to promote the collective good, arguing that each is too individualistic in its current form. Wow. I thought that was kind of the point, to have individual rights. The First and Second Amendments tend to be interpreted in aggressively individualistic ways that ignore the reality of conflict among competing rights.
Oh, no. We can't have individual rights. She already said we had to do stuff for the common good.
So here's what she proposes the First Amendment should say.
Okay.
Every person has the right to freedom of expression, association, peaceful assembly, and petition of the government for redress of grievances, consistent with the rights of others to do the same, and subject to the responsibility for abuses. All conflicts of such rights shall be resolved in accordance with the principle of equality and dignity of all persons.
Yes, equality and dignity, baby. They trump everything.
Both the freedom of religion and the freedom from religion shall be respected by the government. Don't even get me started.
But don't forget about the equity and dignity clause that she wants to insert there. That's important, man.
There's interference endorsements. Okay, so that must be in. Is that in the Second Amendment?
No, that's you just read that. The equity and dignity of others. That's got to be part of the First Amendment. Now, the Second Amendment that she wants to tweak.
Oh, yeah. Okay. That's Second Amendment, too.
That's good stuff.
She advanced the same charge that gun control advocates routinely levy at the Second Amendment, that it is idiosyncratic and anachronistic. Bull crap. According to Franks, the Constitution should not conflate self-defense with the right to use a weapon.
Okay.
Rather, it should promote the right to bodily autonomy.
Wait, whoa, now I'm listening now.
Yeah, you should be, because now it's an anti-pro-life stand.
That doesn't apply to the vaccine argument now.
It's a pro-abortion amendment now. She wants to rewrite the Second Amendment to protect reproductive health. Okay. All right.
Wait, are we still in the Second Amendment?
Yeah.
Are we still in Bible country? What is happening with this?
All people have the right to bodily autonomy consistent with the right of other people to the same.
See, that right there, that's her little workaround on the vaccine thing.
Oh, right.
Like, oh, if you don't get the vaccine, then you're affecting me. Oh, shut up.
Right. Yeah, don't worry about... Now, you can't apply the same thing to the baby growing inside a woman's body. That's a completely different situation. Including the right to defend themselves against unlawful force and the right of self-determination in reproductive matters. The government shall take reasonable measures to protect the health and safety of the public as a whole. That's... I mean, it's amazing that you would even do a story on this. Who is this Yahoo? Some stupid law professor from the University of Miami? Well, it's amazing the importance people attach just because somebody has a law degree or they're a professor at an American university.
It probably has tenure.
It probably.
Can't touch her.
And now they're like, yeah, see, this is a good idea. Let's let's get this going.
No, that's the kind of nonsense right there that you're absolutely right. Who is this chick? Shut up, whatever. Mm-hmm. That there will be a confirmation hearing at the Senate, and some radical that Joe Biden puts up there, some possible judge or whatever, will say, well, a respected law professor, University of Miami, actually said that we should probably revisit a couple of the amendments in the Bill of Rights. And I think that there's some validity to this. This is madness. I mean, education. Kids, don't go to college because you're going to be taught by
people like that. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be law professors. Don't do it.